Yo guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're not already subscribed to Off The Cameras Boxing, like the video, do all of that amazing stuff. Today marks the happened on his 80th birthday, so we wanted to do a tribute on the channel for him. A picture of him on my walls because I'm inspired by him to the absolute max. The quote I'll go is it's a picture of him knocking out Sonny Liston, and the quote is, if you even dream of beating me, you better wake up and apologize. So Muhammad Ali is a very, very special human being to me. And just a bit about him, for those of you guys who don't know 100% of his background, he went from, he came from a middle class background, but there was a lot of racism back in the day. And then he went on to becoming a Olympic gold medalist, came back home. People just, even though he won an Olympic gold medal, he wasn't welcome in certain restaurants and cafes because of the color of his skin. He then went on to become a world champion and beating the likes of Floyd Patterson, George Foreman, Joe Frazier, etc. He done a couple of things outside of the ring, such as saving a few hostages in foreign land. So he's one of the most inspiring people of all time. It's only fair to do a tribute to him. This is Muhammad Ali, the greatest tribute reaction. Okay, so without further ado, let's get cracking.
Float like a butterfly, champ. Rumble, young man.
Is this on close? Utah is alive
right now.
And everybody stop talking now. Attention. I told you, all of my critics, I told you all that I was the greatest of all time. Sonny Liston, I told you today, I'm still the greatest of all time. Never again.
Make me the underdog until I'm about 50 years old. Right. Then you might get me.
Talking about how big George Foreman is, how terrible, I'm scared for my life, how relentless he is. That sucker ain't nothing.
Down goes Frazier. Down goes Frazier. The heavyweight champion is taking the mandatory eight count, and Foreman is as poised as can be.
You can't hack it. You would continue boxing even if you would lose over there.
I beg your pardon.
I'm a brain fighter, scientific, I'm artistic.
This is the hardest hitter since Marciano. This man is greater than Joe Louis. I've been reading what you're saying.
He's a bull. I'm the matador. He's meeting his master, his teacher, his idol.
Well, being us both religious people, Muhammad and myself, he'll be very fortunate if I don't act as an exorcist and beat the devil out of him.
The time may have come to say goodbye to Muhammad Ali. Maybe he can pull off a miracle. But against George Foreman, so young, so strong, so fearless, against George Foreman, who does away with his opponents one after another in less than three rounds, it's hard for me to conjure with that. After this fight, I suspect Ali will retire.
This chump has got everybody scared. Scared of what? Nothing to be scared of. Scared of what?
I'm meeting his heart, but if a man can stay out of the way for five rounds, stick him, move, stay out of range, be in good shape, he'll retire George Foreman. This man depends on getting his man in the first one or two rounds. If he don't do that, he's frustrated. Stick him in left jabs and right crosses, tie him up and box him, and you'll retire.
Ali.
I'm the only man that's going to whoop George Foreman, and I'm going to whoop him of all places in Africa, in the Congo, where the Lumumba boys are. I'm not a hard puncher. I'm not known for being a hard puncher. I fought many men like Floyd Patterson, Zora Foley, George Fowler, who are stronger than I am. Many I couldn't knock out, Sonny Liston. But I'll tell you this, boxing ability, speed, whooping him on points for the distance if necessary. Then I'll whoop him.
That's so tough. Hard work.
Wow.
Oh, you're not that
I'm on the
somebody like Ali, or what's somebody that's really the real deal, you know? And I say, well, did I know I'm that
That's Mike Tyson.
I want to believe that I'm that guy. My ego tells me that, but the reality of it, I love this life that I have. I might not want to give this up just to prove that I'm a tough guy, but Ali would. I always like to think I'm a bad motherfucker, vicious motherfucker, but that's a part of Ali. That's where he overshines me, because I can't understand a man that's willing to just really die. You know, and I talk that shit, but he ain't the real dick. He'll die for this shit. I'm not going to die for that. Ali will fight you till he dies. You have to kill him. I just know I'm not him. I know what greatness is. I know what real greatness is. When you see greatness, then you know that's not me. His punches are coming from nowhere. Bop, 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 bop. In the 15th round, he's still pumping. Bop, bop.
One,
boom,
two.
Boom. He's going to start releasing you. Ali's a giant. There's no way that anybody can match him.
Come get me, sucker. I'm dancing. I'm dancing. Follow me, chump. No, I'm not there. I'm here. What?
This man will never touch me. Don't hit me with the stuff he hit Joe Frazier with.
The heavyweight championship of the world at stake. So the stage is set. We're just about ready to begin.
That's one of the biggest boxing fights of all time, Robin in the Jungle, and that's probably arguably, I think that's the most watched boxing show of all time. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Muhammad Ali coming into the boxing ring for the last time. And Ali is getting the people to chant Ali Mouye. That means Ali Killer. Look at this now as they stare. They're really putting the stare on each other. Look at the stare on George Foreman. Look at Ali giving the word.
He's really mean and tough and determined and competitive. He's rarely game. What make him, why is he that way? It goes beyond himself understanding. Ali goes to the level where I'm afraid to go.
Here we go, Ali quickly across the round. Ali looks like he's ready to go here. He's not staying away, he's going after them. Look at Ali, he continues to talk and talk. Definitely serious. Tremendous combination by Muhammad Ali. Dagger, Foreman staggers. Definitely. Foreman trailing away. And Ali says the second best. Muhammad Ali is taking the punishment now. Two wild right hands taken on the side of the head of Muhammad Ali. There's a real strong right hand hits it into the heart.
Hopefully the next generation and generation afterwards can still learn from his legacy, still be inspired by what he's done in the sport of boxing. Okay, he's been up against some of the tough level opponents, like he said. And this one, Robin in the Jungle. Listen, what can you say about Muhammad Ali? What more is there to say? So thank you for watching the video. Subscribe to Off the Canvas Boxing. Peace, love, prosperity. I'm gonna see you guys in a bit. Peace.